Good morning. I hope you
Yeah.
all are keeping safe and sound during the pandemic, following the social protocols of distancing and wearing masks and sanitizers. I also want to thank Air Crew Aviations for giving me this wonderful opportunity. And I'd just like to share my journey with you guys, along with the topic that I have for today, Envision, Act and Own. So if I ask Envision, I mean, the word itself, it means picturization of a desirable future, right? The first step to envision is actually the visualization, manifestation of what is it that you want. Now, if I ask you guys to close your eyes for 30 seconds and visualize your dream house, most people will fail to do so. Why? Because some might get a glimpse of a mansion or a palace or a wonderful, beautiful beachside house. But how many bedrooms? What kind of a garden? How much parking? Nobody has those exact specifications. And that is exactly what needs more attention. We all want to build a house, a dream house, but we don't know how do we want it to look like. What is it? What exactly it should be like? What material does it require, right? You know, whenever a house is built, months of drafting, planning, and budgeting goes even before the foundation is laid. So many things need to be thought about. So many things there are to be made note of. That where exactly the location, the raw material, the architecture, right? And that is exactly what I'm here to talk about, the goal setting. Goal setting is the step, first step that actually will take us to a desirable future of whatever it is that we want in our life. Now, what do I mean by that? Set a goal. We all have goals in life. We want fancy houses, we want big cars, or we want to be successful. But define that success for yourself. Now, when I wanted to pursue dentistry, so I'm a dental surgeon by profession. Now, when I wanted to pursue dentistry, I knew exactly which colleges I will be applying for, what entrance exams I'll be appearing for, what will be the fee structure, what is the course structure, how is it going to be like, what will be the code of conduct there. I knew all these things. And exactly that's how I prepared for it. Now, setting a goal in life is good, but it starts with the first tiny step towards it, right? Now, life is a big journey, one step at a time. Set a goal for every day. You know, like just when, it could be anything, right? Work towards making yourself 1% better than what you were yesterday. Now, 1% better doesn't mean that drastically I'll become a new person, I'll become a god, or there'll be some light behind my head. No. What I mean is, it could be anything. It could be knowledge, learning, cooking, communication, relationship. Target, make a target of being 1% better than the version you were yesterday. You know, boon boon, ghada bharta, drop by drop, the pitcher actually fills up. Now, once you actually have those goals in place, they cannot be fulfilled by themselves, right? Mere visualization will not help you achieve those goals, right? Like if I want to lose weight, I can't just visualize having six-pack abs and hope to get those by themselves. Now, I have to work towards those, right? I can't eat a cheese hamburger and expect that I'll have six-pack abs, right? I need to take a balanced diet. I need to start working out. Right? But six-pack abs isn't desirable, is a wishful thought, I'll say. Okay. Now, it doesn't bother me if I climb a flight of stairs, or let's say a 7 flight of stairs, and my knees start to hurt. Now, that is a ringing alarm, right? I cannot risk my mobility due to me being overweight or anything like that. I have to work on myself. I have to work on my fitness. Now, that becomes a burning desire. I can't just sit back and hope ki mera weight kam ho jayega, I'll probably be a fitter self. Now, you know, most people will, now with 31st December and 1st of January being around the corner, a lot of us will have those fitness goals for ourselves. For the new year, 2021, we'll go to the gym, we'll hit the yoga studio, we'll hit the Zumba studio, we'll start eating, right? But all these things actually go to a complete vein when it comes to working on those, right? Actions require discipline and consistency. Only then you can actually get those desired results. Now, Sachin Tendulkar did not become a master blaster overnight. He gave hours and hours of training, probably sleepless nights. Probably he might not have eaten as well for so many hours, and he was training rigorously, right? Now, it requires perseverance. There will be times when, you know, there'll be ups and downs in life. Sabke saath hota hai, you know, nobody expected pandemic to happen. None of us knew that there'll be a time in our lives when life altogether will come to a complete halt, right? Now, irrespective of the circumstances, I cannot compromise on my action plan, right? I might be sick some days. That doesn't mean that I don't eat right. That does not give me an excuse to actually skip on the balanced diet that I'm supposed to be taking, right? Or probably skip on my yoga, or it could be anything. It could be my fitness regime. I cannot expect to actually skip on those and give myself excuses, right? A lot of conditions. See, I'll tell you, I was working in a dental clinic and I worked there for almost 3.5-4 years, and I enjoyed dentistry thoroughly, okay? That was one thing. I was, during my teenage, I had braces, and my orthodontist was a lady. So that was almost more than a decade ago, that was something new that I was looking at. I never knew an orthodontist as a lady before. And she inspired me. I underwent that treatment for almost 2 years. And she was the primary reason I wanted to pursue dentistry in the very first place, because she inspired me a lot. Now, when I was practicing dentistry, I learned so many things. I enjoyed each and every clinical procedure. But again, I did not, I mean, after a few years, I realized that I don't want to do this for the rest of my life. One reason being because I wanted to grow more as a person. And then I switched to the non-clinical sector. I worked with multiple startups, mostly into the healthcare background. But until the pandemic came, I was working with one of my friends. We were working on a medical tourism startup. But due to the pandemic, everything came to a halt for us also. All the operations stopped, because you understand that tourism is one industry which was majorly hit by the pandemic. And everything, we had no idea that all these operations will resume when. It's been almost 10 months now. We still don't have a clue that when will everything come back to normal. It probably might not, might never, right? So I understood that I was working there into business development, and business development also was a great revelation to me, because I understood my love for communication, communicating with new personalities, new people, because that gives me a chance to, that actually gives me more exposure to different variety of people, where I get to learn a lot, right? So that's how I ended up working. I'm currently working into business development for a branding agency. Now, dentistry to branding, these are poles apart industries. Now, I can't put any logic to it, because it's my life, right? I decided that I'll take charge of how things are going to be for me. I had belief on myself and my capabilities. I made a roadmap. During the pandemic, I was also one of those people who was probably cooking new things and trying to learn new skills, right? From financial awareness to SEO to multiple other things. But I realized that I can't expect other people to understand where am I coming from and where am I going. It's my life. I have taken the ownership to make things happen for me. I got blessed with wonderful opportunities, which I did not let slip by. I was always open to learning, right? See, dental surgeon to business development executive, it's been a beautiful journey so far. And, you know, we only have this one life. But if I do this once correctly, once is enough. You know, Krishna says in Mahabharata that most people, we don't change this according to the changes that happen around us. We like blaming everything. I mean, we like blaming life for everything that happens, that, oh, humare sath ye galat ho gaya, why did this happen to us? We like playing that sympathy card. Now, I, for once, have always been very stern about the decision-making that I've done so far. I take full ownership of all my decisions. I took dentistry. I pursued dentistry. I loved it. I switched to the non-clinical. I took full ownership of that. I came to the branding and business development. I take full ownership of that, and I am enjoying it thoroughly. Now, that actually has been the motto of my life, because whatever I do, I give my 100%. I intend to work and reach greater heights in this particular domain. No decision ever can be either right or wrong. It's either a blessing or a learning. Either ways, you get to learn a lot, right? Now, I understood that, you know, introspection is the first step towards anything that you want to achieve. Now, I introspected that definitely I wanted to pursue healthcare as a dentistry as my main domain, but that wasn't giving me fulfilling outcomes that I wanted. That it did for some time, but not for a very long time. And I understood that I need to go out and do more things. Now, you know, when goal setting comes in place, always setting a goal for myself which is achievable, it was very important to me. See, I till date, okay, I I set one night before, I always make a plan that how my next day is going to look like. And that has always helped me. Even during the pandemic, even though I'm not going out, I still make a to-do list that how my day is going to look like. Otherwise, I'm just roaming around like a headless chicken, right? I don't know what is it that needs to be done. How is it that needs to be done? I have to have that surety that, okay, even if I have to go take my mom outside or go to visit the doctor or go to the park or be it anything, I jot it down in my planner so that I know that, yes, this is what all I achieved. This is what I need to achieve. And this all is pending, right? That is one thing that I realized, that making a goal for yourself, it could be, setting a goal, let's see, if you want to achieve something 10 years down the line, a decade, okay? Now a decade is a very long way to go, right? You, to achieve that main target, there are multiple things that you need to do now, right? One step at a time, which I spoke about. Now it could be anything, right? Learning a new skill, or probably practicing that new skill, or probably whatever you've learned so far, putting it into use. It could be anything. It could be right from coding to clinical. It could be anything that you want to do. Now, but you need to be very clear in your head that, yes, this is where I want to go. Now, how you want to go, that is the question that comes later. First, you need to clear your head that, okay, this is what I want to achieve. How many parameters do you have? Let's say I want to become an actress. Now, I need to go to an acting school first. Right? Even if not an acting school, I need to upgrade my skill set to that. From business development, I need to be open to learning new skill set, which will help me actually reach that point that I become a capable actor. Right? So, you know, everything in life altogether, you know, the challenges or the ups and downs, like during this pandemic, so these challenging times, a lot of people actually became opportunists. You know, I know we all know people around us who faced a lot of adversities, but at the same time, so many people came up with so many new opportunities, and they're flourishing like how, right? Right from manufacturing those PP kits in their parking lots or probably in their verandas to these outlets, the food delivery outlets, right? I mean, every sector, there are so many sectors, there were so many opportunities that a lot of us could have pursued, right? I know so many of my friends who started teaching the needy students, right? They probably not be making any money out of it, but it gives them immense pleasure to actually help the needy, right? And that is how life has to be lived. You know, when I was, I also helped my sister. She's into a startup. She's manufacturing feminine hygiene products, and it's been a challenging phase for her as well, but keeping myself and keeping her motivated was the one thing that I always intended to do. See, because it's very easy to get disheartened, but actually being at your goal, irrespective, no matter come what may, I know that this is what I have to achieve, and I know that this is how I want to proceed. Now, that was the more important thing to me. You know, Shah Rukh Khan ka famous dialogue, kisi cheez ko puri shiddat se chaho to, sorry, I don't know the complete thing, I'm not a Shah Rukh Khan fan, but it's an actual proven law, a law that states that whatever I want, I can manifest for myself. Right, the law, law of attraction, the secret. It's a very famous law. Whatever I want in my life, I can actually manifest it just the way it has to be. But first, I have to visualize it. Now, visualization is not a very tricky part, but then I have to, you know, it was a bit too difficult for me because I'm always a person of logic. I always look for science into things. But this concept completely changed my thought process because I actually gave a lot of introspection. I sat with myself and I tried. I mean, try visualizing. There are so many times that you also might have you experienced that. Let's say probably you're driving and you need to reach your destination. And sometimes you'll just find all the signals green because you're in a hurry. Now you probably think that you're blessed and you're lucky at this, that you'll be able to reach your destination in time. It's nothing but the law of attraction actually working in the back. Right? The universe actually helping you reach your destination faster. A lot of time we're all craving for tea and somebody comes up probably at home or in school or in college or in a cafe that chal, let's go for a coffee or let's go for a sip of tea. Right? It's nothing but again, the visualization that is happening at the subconscious level. Right? So setting a target, backtracking it and then working on it with perseverance. no matter what comes. That is one thing that I understood and I implemented and I achieved it, right? So, you know, months, I mean, you know, it's been almost 10 months and pandemic has been, I think it's been a learning curve for all of us, you know, right from spending so much time with our families and not spending all the time on the social media and the digital gadgets or anything. Now that also has given me a lot of hope because I understood that this is where I was lacking in life. And this is also one thing that I wanted to achieve in the longer run, that I want to spend more time with my family. And thankfully this pandemic gave me that opportunity that what I wanted to achieve probably somewhere down the line, because we're all working people. My parents are, they're also working professionals. I'm also working. My sister's also working. So we as a family did not used to get so much time together. But thankfully to the pandemic that came into our life, it really, really helped us gel back together as a family. I think we all needed that kind of a break. We were all yearning for that. Kabhi to mil jaye, kahi to opportunity mil jaye, but nahi mil rahi thi. And I took this opportunity because this opportunity also gave me time to spend that extra time that I had in my hands on my sister's business, which right now is flourishing to the next level. We're making it happen. Things are happening like very wonderfully for us. The manufacturing is happening at a very good scale and the production and the circulation, the distribution, also everything is going just as we planned, rather better than we planned. So I think I took this, all of us in my family, if I talk about, we all took this time, sat down and worked things through. So, you know, I just want to tell you guys that envisioning and acting and taking those ownership, because there'll be mistakes that happen. Okay. I also made mistakes. I also took some wrong calls, but that doesn't mean that I don't take responsibility. You know, responsibility equals accountability equals ownership. All these things collectively make me as a person who I am. If I'm doing something wrong, if I, let's say probably, it could be anything. Let's say even if I mistreated a patient, I mean, some clinical error that occurred, I would take full ownership and ensure that I do not make that mistake again. Taking ownership doesn't mean just merely accepting that something wrong happened. Taking ownership means even if there's a mistake that happened, you correct it the next time. You ensure that it does not happen again. Right. I just want to share a little quick video with you guys. I can share the screen, right? Yes, I can. Just give me a second. I came across this wonderful video. I just hope you also like it. I think. Can you hear it? Am I audible? No. Audible? Sorry. So you saw how this wonderful flower made back to life. So it's typically our own story. If I mean, irrespective, no matter what comes our way, a lot of times ups and downs comes, but I take charge, I take ownership, and I make things happen for myself. I don't give excuses. I don't blame life. I don't blame circumstances, because they're merely, I mean, they're temporary, right? All the circumstances that are in and about happening around us, they're all temporary things that are happening, right? I take full charge and I make things happen for myself. So yes, thank you so much. I am done. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to ask me if you have any.
Any guys, any questions, type in the chat box.
Don't have any questions in the chat box.
They are upset, I guess. Dentist has come. Raja Rajeshwari. Any questions you have? Anyone else?
Yeah,
sir. Anna, Nisha, Mansi.
No, sir.
It's good opportunity for you to ask the question if you have any question about life, about happiness. Even you can ask about immunity, hygiene, anything from the doctor.
Anything. I'll be more than happy to answer.
You can contribute this.
Okay. We would like to propose a hearty vote of thanks to you, Bhavna Vishraj, for raising today's webinar on a topic of aviation by own. I'm sure that all the participants have taken note of your suggestion and further universe in their career. Lastly, I thank you again for the whole team of Aqua Aviation Private Limited team